Arriving in Manila after changing planes at Ieshima, Lieutenant General Kawabe, head of the Japanese surrender mission, formally salutes Colonel S.F. Mashbir, coordinator of the Allied Translator Interrogation Section. The enemy surprises the colonel with a sudden handshake, which fails of its purpose. The Jap Vice Chief of Staff salutes his junior in rank, Major General Willoughby, MacArthur's Intelligence Chief. Arriving at the Manila City Hall for the surrender terms, General Kawabe leads the 16 Jap members in the surrender of their proud sidearms, which they wore from the homeland. Lieutenant General Richard Sutherland, MacArthur's Chief of Staff, presents a stern, unyielding countenance to the enemy. Kawabe offers his credentials, authorizing him and his associates to represent the Imperial Japanese government. Newsreel and Signal Corps cameramen record the historic presentation. General Sutherland leaves to consult with staff members and later calls General Kawabe and his mission to a conference which lasts far into the night. At these sessions, the final terms are dictated to the Japanese delegation for delivery to the emperor and his subjects. The tone of the meetings is cool and deliberate. The aim of the Americans is to bring about a quick cessation of armed hostilities and the arrangement of immediate surrender. The occupation terms are complete. The beaten foe can only accept the inevitable. After years of brutal aggression in Asia and the Pacific, the Nips finally met an invincible opponent with a fleet second to none. And with plenty of supplies aboard, it will be anchors away for Tokyo itself. There'll be plenty of supplies needed, because our mighty army of occupation won't leave until the Jap is fit to live in a peace-loving, democratic world. Navy pictures show battleships, cruisers, carriers, destroyers, fighting craft of every kind as far as the eye can reach. A sight the Japs will never forget.